Like traditional worship, and when I say something that needs an amen, you give me an amen. When I say something that needs a yes, you give me a yes. When I say something that needs hallelujah, you give me hallelujah. And then we say, okay, today was different, and next time when you come, we'll go back to the normal thing. Praise the Lord. And so it says, verily, verily, I say unto you, that ye shall weep and lament, but the world shall rejoice, and ye shall be sorrowful, but your sorrow shall be turned into joy. Yeah. In verse 21, a woman, when she is in travail, has sorrow, because her hour is come. Her hour is come. But as soon as she is delivered of the child, she remembereth no more the anguish for the joy that a man is born into the world. She remembereth no more the anguish. You know, there are some people, they take joy in keeping their sorrow. And if you want to turn them around, cheer them up, encourage them, make them lively again, they say, no, this is a time of sorrow for me. I want to be sorrowful. I don't want you, don't make me laugh. Don't make me happy. Don't make me joyful. Don't give me any promise. Just remind me of my loss, and just remind me of my pain, and just remind me of what I'm going through. They like to remain in the negative. And you know the negative is in the dark room where the devil goes to develop a bad picture. You know, when a photographer, when he takes a picture and he wants to develop it into reality, into a picture, he goes to the dark room. And when you take all those negative events in your life and you enter into the dark room and you never come out for fresh air, you never come out for sunshine, you never come out to interact with us, you never come out to see our faces and, you know, share with us, you remain in that dark room, and then the devil is developing the picture. By the time you come out, you are more miserable than when I saw you yesterday. Come out and come into the sunshine, and let the sunshine and the fellowship of the people of God cheer you up, and then you'll become a happy man, a happy woman once again in Jesus' name. It says, she remembers no more the anguish for joy that a man child, a man is born into the world. In verse 22, it says, and ye now therefore have sorrow, but I will see you again, and your heart shall rejoice, and your joy, tell me the rest. Again, did I hear you? Do you know something? Anytime, and the people of the world, this is their, they don't understand. They don't understand. This is all the thing they are thinking about. The people of the world, there's only one road they know. Anything that happens to you as a child of God, they'll come to you, they'll say, do you know? Do you know that thing that you lost, your job? That thing that you lost, my brother, your wife, that thing that you lost, you know, they'll say, is the witch, is the wizard. Some of them, you don't know even how to call witch, they say winch. They say, you know, that thing that you lost is winch that has taken away. And then they say, if you get another one, the winches are still there. And they will take it away again. It's a lie. I said it's a lie. Yeah. Praise the Lord. Yeah. It's wonderful to read the Bible. It's wonderful to know the Lord. It's wonderful to know that you lost a job, you lost a husband, you lost a wife, you lost a child, you lost a daddy, you lost a mommy. It's not witch, it's not winch. It is what was written concerning you. And because this is what was written from all eternity, God knew before that time that this is what will happen. There's no witch that can touch you. No witch can touch your wife. And no witch can touch your husband. We are the children of God, and the heirs of your head are all numbered. And you are more valuable than many sparrows. And because of that, the Lord is taking care of us. And then when God gives you another husband, another wife, another child again, some people come to you and say, I learned that you got married again. The winches said that they are coming again. Go back and tell them that we don't believe in winches. What do you believe in? We believe in Jesus. And Jesus has given every brother, every sister here assurance. What God gives you will remain permanent in Jesus' name. And so the Lord said, your joy no man taketh from you. And then it says, verse 23, and in that day ye shall ask me nothing. Verily, verily, I say unto you, whatsoever, are you there? Whatsoever ye shall ask the Father in my name, tell me the rest, he will give it to you. The Lord is telling you today that he will answer your prayer. Any burden in your heart, any sorrow in your heart, any loss you have sustained, the Lord is telling you that he himself is going to take care of you. Sweet is the promise, I will not forget you. And so you can have the joy that there's no forgetfulness in the sight of the Lord. It's going to answer your prayer. And then he tells us in verse 24, he says, hitherto have ye asked nothing in my name. Ask, and you shall receive, that your joy may be full. These things have I spoken unto you in Proverbs. But the time cometh when I shall no more speak unto you in Proverbs, but I shall show you plainly of the Father. At that day ye shall ask in my name, and I say not that I will pray to the Father for you, for the Father himself loveth you, because ye have loved me and have believed that I came out from God. In verse 28, I came forth from the Father, and I'm come into the world, and again I leave the world and go where? To the Father. The Lord is telling you that he will answer your prayer. Therefore, you wash away all that dark thing you have and all the sorrow you have, because the time of rejoicing has come for you. In John chapter 14, verses 13 and 14, and whatsoever ye shall ask in my name, that I will do, that the Father may be glorified in the Son. In verse 14, if ye shall ask anything, today you will ask. And I'm giving assurance from the Lord, it will be given to you. If you shall ask anything in my name, I will do it. Chapter 15, verse 7. Chapter 15, verse 7. If ye abide in me, and my words abide in you, ye shall ask what ye will, and what? It shall be done unto you. Look at verse 16. Ye have not chosen me, but I have chosen you and ordained you that you should go forth and bring, and you should go and bring forth fruit, and that your fruit should remain, and that whatsoever ye shall ask of the Father in my name, he may give it you. You are going to have it. Luke chapter 11, verse 9. Luke chapter 11, we're reading from verse 9. Luke 11, looking at it from verse 9. It says, and I say unto you, ask, and it shall be given unto you. Seek, and ye shall find. Knock, and it shall be opened unto you. For everyone that asketh receiveth, and he that seeketh findeth, and to him that knocketh it shall be opened. Then it says, if a son shall ask bread of any of you that say, Father, will he give him a stone? Or if he ask a fish, will he give him a serpent? Or if he ask an egg, will he offer him a scorpion? If ye then, being evil, know how to give good gifts unto your children, how much less? What's it there? How much more? Everybody say, how much more? It's coming in your life. Yeah. It will come. Yeah. How much more shall your heavenly Father give the Holy Ghost to them that ask him? 1 John chapter 3. In 1 John chapter 3, we're reading now from verse 22. 1 John chapter 3. And we're reading from verse 22. And whatsoever we ask, we receive of him, because we keep his commandments and do those things that are pleasing in his sight. Whatsoever we ask. It's only if we don't ask. You know, there's some of us that we don't ask. Look up here for a moment. I've looked at my life. There are many things I don't even ask for. Since I became born again, the day I became born again, my interest was just to preach to other, just preach to people. My students at that time with the Scripture Union. And then when I became like, you know, a graduate, and all I wanted to do was just buy books and send to people. And if you ask me, what do I need? I don't know what I need. I don't need anything. I'm all right. I said, I'm all right. But you know, everything I've got, call it house, call it clothes, and I don't remember since when last I bought any clothes, and I have extra that, you know, if I know your size, I could give you some of mine. Praise the Lord. And even the shoes, I don't know how they know my size. You know, I go to this city and, you know, a bag is what, and they say, you know, Pastor, this. You know, sometimes, you know, in one country recently, they had Mother's Day. Mother's Day. Think about that. And then when they had Mother's Day, then they said, our mommy is gone, but her daddy is still alive. You know what they mean? I said, you know what they mean. They said, our mommy is gone, but her dad is still alive. And then they went, they bought this and bought this and bought this. And they said, because of Mother's Day. And then they said, that is working for the pastor. And he just informed me, I've not seen it yet. I've not known what it is yet. Somebody just phoned me and said, Pastor, when are you coming to us? Because next time you come, there's a big bag waiting for you. I said, what's in that bag? He said, when you come, you'll see it. Praise the Lord. I'm not even asking, and it's coming. And whatever you are asking will come. And even the things you are not asking, if God knows that you need, it will come in Jesus' name. And that's the joy we have in this Christian fold as children of God. We just say, Lord, I leave that in your hand. And whatever it is, don't just take care of your children. It says there, whatsoever ye shall ask, he will give it unto you. We receive of him because we keep his commandments and do those things that are pleasing in his sight. Your blessing will come. First John chapter 5, and we're reading from verse 14. And this is the confidence that we have in him. Do you have any confidence in God today? This is the confidence that we have in him, that if we ask anything according to his will, he heareth us. And if we know that he heareth us, he hears us. Whatsoever we ask, we know that we have the petitions that we desire of him. You are going to have your petition fulfilled. Ephesians chapter 3, we're looking at verse 20. Now unto him that is able to do exceeding abundantly above all that we ask or think, according to the power that worketh in us. That power will work in you. And so the Lord Jesus Christ assured his own disciples, wipe your tears away, take your sorrow away, and take the sadness away, because himself has said, whatever you ask, even though he's not here present physically, is gone to heaven, whatever you ask him, he will give unto you. Point number 3, the perception and protection by the shepherd. The perception and the protection by the shepherd. Verse 29 of John chapter 16. His disciples said unto him, Lord, now speakest thou plainly and speakest no proverb. They said, now we perceive, now we understand. And it is not a parable anymore. This one is clear, plain, and practical. And now we're sure that thou knowest all things, and needest not that any man should ask thee. By this we believe that thou camest forth from God. Jesus answered them, do ye now believe? Behold, the hour cometh, yea, is now come, when ye shall be scattered every man to his own, and shall leave me alone, and yet I am not alone. Are you alone? Yet I'm not alone, because the Father is with me. Brothers and sisters, look up again. You know, here we need to understand. It says in verse 32, it says, ye shall be scattered, every man to his own, and ye shall leave me alone. I'm trying to make all these verses come clear and come plain to you, so that in your life you will understand. Let's understand this. Jesus labored upon all these disciples. He gathered them together. and they were the joy of his life, because that's the fruit of his ministry. And then the Lord said, you'll be scattered. Everyone will go to his own, and all of you will leave me alone, as if all my work, everything, has now gone into the drain. But then he said, I will see you again in another verse. Because Jesus concentrated on, you will see me again, on the future glory, on the pleasure, on the satisfaction, that the scattering is only temporary, that the gathering together will be the permanent thing. Can I make an illustration for you? You know, many years ago, as this deeper life started, we had many people, faithful children of God, and faithful members of deeper life. And eventually, as we, you know, continued, there were some of them, you know, in leadership, there are times you have to take decisions in leadership. And then you will say, my brother, we need somebody there, you go here, you go there. And some of the people at that time, they came unhappy with me, and some of them just said, Pastor, I will not accept that transfer. If it is like that, I'm going. And I pleaded with them, don't go. Come here. And they said, no, except you reverse that. And I said, come. If I transfer you, and then because you reject, I kind of say, I suppress it. I go back. I'll never be able to transfer anybody anymore. Because they'll say, if you want to reject transfer, this is how to deal with the pastor. I said, please, my brother, stay. He said, no, I will not stay. So they went. This one went, and this one went, and this one went, and that one went. And it's like, everything is catching. It's like, leadership. You know how to lead people, how to control people. You go here, you go there. Now they are scattered. You know, if I concentrated on that, I'd be paralyzed. I'd not be able to do anything. But you know, this year, I was, you have heard the story, but I'll tell you the story. You want to hear? This year I went to Abuja, and then, you know, a state overseer, he was a former state overseer. And I transferred him, and he left. And he paid me, because they used to call him my son. Anytime he preached, his voice almost like my voice. He's everything, that it was almost like me. And I loved him, and he loved me. And sometimes he reminded me this year, I wanted to preach somewhere, and I had some little physical challenge, and I gave him my notes. I said, that's my note, go and use it and preach. And then I sat and listened to him, and I was so happy. It's just like me preaching. But when I transferred him, he just left. And at that time, the sorrow was deep in my heart. Another one also left. The sorrow was much as it just left and left like that. The people, I just felt, these were the foundation and the pillars. But this year, when I got to Abuja, this fellow that left, he came back again. And he saw me and he said, you're my father.